Hello, ArtSciTech viewers. Today, I invite you to completely rethink the concept of intelligence. We often associate intelligence with the human brain, or maybe with artificial intelligence systems. But what if the silent heroes of nature, plants, offered us a whole new perspective? In this video, we'll explore plant intelligence and dive into their quiet yet astonishing world. So let's redefine what intelligence means and see what role plants might play in that story. Is intelligence only about complex reasoning or language skills? Or could it be a hidden wisdom tucked in the branches of a tree or the movement of a vine? To begin answering that, we first need to tackle a fundamental question. What is intelligence, and how important is having a brain in that equation? Before we dive in, we've passed 5,000 subscribers and are well on our way to 10,000. Thank you so much. But I do have one request. Although views are great, our watch time is low. So please, watch this video to the end with full attention. It really helps. Intelligence is typically defined as the ability to solve problems, learn, and adapt to one's environment. Humans and some animals achieve this through their nervous systems and brains. But how do brainless plants fit into this definition? Surprisingly, scientific studies show that plants can react to environmental changes, learn, and even exhibit something akin to decision-making. Yes, you heard that right. Plants can demonstrate intelligence-like behavior without a central nervous system. To truly understand this mysterious world, we need to dive into a relatively new scientific field, plant neurobiology. So what exactly is plant neurobiology teaching us? Plant neurobiology studies how plants perceive, process, and respond to environmental signals. Don't let the word neuro fool you. Plants don't have neurons, but they communicate using chemical and electrical signals. For example, when you touch a plant's leaf, calcium ions move through its cells, similar to how nerve signals work in animals. This shows us that plants are not passive organisms. They actively sense and respond to their surroundings. When a leaf is chewed by an insect, a plant can detect the threat and activate chemical defenses. But is this merely a reflex or a sign of something deeper? Let's take a closer look. Plant responses to threats may seem like simple reflexes on the surface. Take the mimosa plant, also called the sensitive plant. Its leaves fold rapidly when touched. But some reactions are far more complex. Certain plants emit chemical signals into the air to warn neighboring plants about danger. This could be seen as a form of social intelligence. By sharing information, plants improve their chances of survival. If intelligence involves processing external information and generating appropriate responses, then plants certainly qualify. And their intelligence doesn't stop at defense. Let's explore how they react to light. We've all seen a potted plant leaning toward the window. This behavior, called phototropism, goes beyond simple movement. Plants evaluate the direction and intensity of light and adjust their growth accordingly. Take a climbing vine, it can assess which branch is stronger to climb. This decision-making process happens through chemical signals and hormones. In a way, plants perform calculations and choose optimal growth strategies. This means their intelligence isn't just reactive, it's strategic. But could these strategies rely on some form of memory? Yes, plants have memory. In experiments, mimosa plants exposed repeatedly to harmless stimuli, like gentle shaking, eventually stop folding their leaves. Even more fascinating, this learned behavior persists. When exposed to the same stimulus later, they remember it. This shows that plants can not only sense their environment, but also learn and retain information. Their memory doesn't work like ours, of course, but it gives us valuable insight into the learning capacities of nature. And the key to this might lie in what we call distributed intelligence. Plant intelligence doesn't rely on a centralized brain. Instead, it operates through a distributed system. Leaves, roots, stems, all communicate in a network, functioning more like a team than a hierarchy. This system allows plants to respond rapidly and efficiently to environmental changes. For instance, when roots detect a nearby water source, that information spreads and influences the plant's growth direction. Without a brain, the whole plant works in harmony, and this distributed model closely mirrors artificial intelligence systems. So what are the parallels? I'd like to pause the video here, because to celebrate reaching 10,000 subscribers, I'm launching a brand new concept, a series where we scientifically analyze the powers of cinematic heroes. For example, could Iron Man's suit work? Are Spider-Man's webs even possible? You're curious too, right? Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. Plant intelligence resembles neural networks in AI. Just like an AI model learns from data and makes decisions, plants process environmental signals to develop survival strategies. An AI might analyze multiple data points to solve a problem. Likewise, plants assess light, moisture, and nutrients to guide their growth. This shows how deeply nature and technology are intertwined. In fact, future AI systems might benefit from mimicking the quiet efficiency of plants. But is plant intelligence just about survival, or do plants create beauty too? Plant growth patterns often follow visually stunning designs. The spirals of a sunflower or the symmetry of tree branches express a kind of mathematical beauty. Take the Fibonacci sequence, which frequently appears in leaf arrangements. It's an efficient strategy for absorbing light, but it also looks beautiful to us. Is this just biological necessity or a form of unconscious artistic expression? Perhaps plants, in their own way, remind us that beauty is a universal language. By the way, stay tuned for a future video all about Fibonacci. Talking to plants sounds like sci-fi, but we're getting closer. Scientists are analyzing chemical and electrical signals to interpret plant responses. For example, by detecting stress signals, we could improve agricultural methods or even develop real-time plant feedback systems. And with AI integration, we might someday converse with plants through technology. This would revolutionize farming, but it could also change how we relate to nature. And that brings us to the deeper question. Understanding plant intelligence increases our respect for nature. Plants aren't just oxygen machines or food sources, they are active learners and adaptive decision makers. But a silent intelligence reminds us how complex and valuable life truly is. If we want a more sustainable future, we should learn from their wisdom. Their resilience and harmony with the environment could inspire new ways of thinking, living, and designing technology. Dear ArtSciTech viewers, today we journeyed through the quiet but powerful world of plants. We discovered that intelligence is not exclusive to human brains or artificial systems. Plants teach us that real intelligence can be decentralized, adaptive, and deeply connected to the environment. Perhaps true intelligence isn't about solving puzzles, but about living in harmony with the world. So, where do you think true intelligence lies? Leave your thoughts in the comments, give the video a like, and don't forget to subscribe. In the next episode, who knows what other secrets of nature we'll uncover? See you soon.